So I've been waiting about 7-8 months for these, and as you can see in the background there, there is one of the Rush Wizards set up alongside one of my old Extremes. It's not going to be a great comparison because I think the lamp in this one is probably a couple of years old in the Extreme. So compared to a brand new lamp from the Rush Wizard, it might be a bit unfair, but it should give you an idea. But size-wise, I'm sure you can see there, quite a difference in size. The weight on it is remarkably light compared to the Extreme. I have to use two arms to get that one up in the air normally onto the stand. The Rush Wizard, one hand quite easily you can lift that up, which is going to be a great improvement. So yeah, it's got the rubberized finish on it, which I think will work well, and hopefully it won't scratch like the old one used to. Although that it's got a few little marks here, not you can really see them. On the back, I have noticed that it's 5-pin DMX and not 3-pin, and it's also got your PowerCon connectors on there. Very similar to bracket to what there was before, which means just use your standard Ultimax clamp to take it up. I haven't actually powered this unit up yet, it's literally just come out of the box, so I'm going to power it up and see what it can do. So here it is, powering up for the first time. One thing I do notice is the fan on it is quite noisy actually, compared to the other one. Not sure if you can actually pick that up on there. But you can see there, and this has been on a few seconds. So unlike the original Wizard, it took a good probably 5 minutes for it to actually get up to a decent brightness. You have to excuse what it's projecting onto. The unit is just, ooh, those colours are nice. The unit's currently having some work done on it, so having a new office built at the moment, and I've got a stash of cars in here, so there's not a huge amount of room. Okay, so, like I say, please excuse the mess, but this is pure daylight, and you can see how well that is actually projecting. Now, the Extreme is actually on as well. I think you can just about kind of make some of it out on the ceiling there. Now, bearing in mind, this lamp is probably a couple of years old, so it's not the greatest of comparisons, but hopefully you should get an idea of how bright this Rush is. Oh, I'm so happy. Okay, what I'm also going to do now, I'm going to drop the lights off in here. Not sure if you're going to make a huge amount of difference, and pop some music on, just see what sound that activated mode's like. I tend to use my stuff DMX'd up, it is nice just to have the ability, but I'm not really sure if you can really see how bright this thing is, but it is immense. And still the original there. And it's out of focus, I think, with the Extreme. So like I say, it's not the fairest of tests, but it just gives you a comparison. So if you have got an Extreme that you've had for a couple of 3 years, not changed the lamp in, this will be the kind of improvement you'll get with it. Okay, so this is with the unit lights off, but still in daylight. The Rush seems to constantly do the twirling effects, whereas the Extreme just seems to sit there. But I'm hoping you can see the difference in beams. Okay, I know the Extreme's on green, so let's just knock it off. Yeah, it's got a yellow. Yellow v yellow. And again, you can see that the mirrors on the Extreme a little bit dirty as well. So it's not the ideal comparison, but you can just see how crisp the beams are from the Rush. Okay, so this is actually set on quite a low sound sensitivity, or you can just about read that. But we actually have six different shows that are built in which you can select. I haven't really gone through it enough yet to realise what they all do, but you can select the different shows in there, or seven I suppose if you include zero. Sound sensitivity, very handy. I've dropped this right down because it was on 90 as a preset. But I will try it again on 50. More than anything with this unit, it is the weight of it, which is remarkably light. Now, I haven't found so far, guys, I'm afraid, the Rose Gobo. I haven't even looked through the manual to see if it is in there. But whilst it's been on test, I haven't actually seen it appear. But the optics are, well, just outstanding. It is a bit dusty. I'm not sure if you can see it on there, but the mirror is a bit dusty, but it's probably a safe reflection as to what most Wizard owners or Extreme owners' Wizards are actually going to be like. You know, a bit of dust here and there. I think the mirrors and the lens was cleaned a couple of months ago, so it's due for another clean. But so like I say, not an exact like-for-like comparison, but I would assume that's the kind of difference you would notice between your Wizard Extreme and the Rush Wizard. Colours are absolutely stunning, even going down to the darker colours like the purples, which doesn't really seem to pick up very well on there, but it's actually the purple and blue, because of course we've got split colours in. That's your light blue there. Now this is with no sound on, so it's my only thing I've noticed so far, but I haven't gone into it in enough depth to see if I can just have it on a fixed state when there is no sound. Okay, we are in full daylight. Well, full daylight to a degree. We do have a number of skylights in the unit, which I can't black out, unfortunately. So I'm hoping to do a bit more footage tonight when it gets a bit darker. But this should give you a good indication of how bright it is compared to the Extreme. Just a bit of footage there of it going onto our new stud walling. This is with the split colour activated, which, to be honest, I'm not a huge fan of because it only seems to touch some of them. I'll have to grab one of the other units out just to make sure it's not just slightly out of alignment. You can see the original Extreme behind it. Granted, the Extreme's a couple of metres further away, so obviously it's not going to be as intense. Just going through some of the gobos for you. And this is the unit, I think it's on show mode zero, with a sensitivity of 50% on the microphone. But it's still doing quite crazy things, to be honest. If you look in there, you can actually see what's called the twinkle effect, where it's got the facet which is going in front of the gobo to give a twinkling effect, which I think is going to look amazing for the first dance. So for those of you that are missing out on your rose gobo, you will have this twinkle effect, which breaks up the gobo. Wizard Extremes up for grabs with the flight cases. So if anybody's interested in the some Wizard Extremes going cheap, the Salomon pairs, including a twin flight case, you can see in fairly good condition, needs a bit of a tidy up and could possibly do with a new lamp, but I don't think it's excessive. It's just in comparison to the Rush Wizard there. There we go, the Rush Wizard, the newbie. I'll do another video when we've got all of the units up linked together, see what kind of show that they do when they're in master slave mode. Hope you've enjoyed it.